we are going to learn two ways how to calculate loan amortization Google Sheet. When we talk about loan amortization, it means that our monthly payment stays the same, but the amount that is applied to the principal and interest changes every month. Mortgage loans are a good example of loans with amortization. Let's say we need to borrow $5,000 and the interest rate is 4.99%, and most interest rates are provided as annual interest rates. Now the duration for a loan is going to be 2 years. So the first thing we want to calculate is monthly payment. Now before we do that, I'm also going to convert my interest rate and my loan duration to monthly amounts. So the 4.99%, that's an annual rate, so I need to divide it by 12 in order to find out what's the monthly interest rate. To calculate the number of months, I have to multiply the loan duration by 12. Then I'm going to use the Google Sheet PMT formula. Why? Because you do not want to do it by hand. The calculation for monthly payment is super complicated, and this is one case where you do want to use the formula. The PMT function has 5 variables. The first 3 are required and the last 2 are optional. The first one is the interest rate. We need to link it to our monthly interest rate. The second one is the number of payments to be made, so we know it's going to be 24 months. And the third required variable is the present value, which is the amount of loan. If we just link it to the $5,000, the monthly payment becomes negative, so we want to put a negative in front of the present value. You can also put future value, which is what you expect the loan to be at the end of this calculation. But by default, it's 0, so we're just going to leave it at that. In a loan amortization table, for each payment, we want to know the beginning balance of our loan, the payment amount, how much of the payment is principal and interest, the end balance for our loan, and cumulative interest. First, I'm going to list the number of payments, and we have 24 months to pay off our loan. Then I can add a date. I don't have to, but I want to put a date when I'm going to start paying the loan, and then use the e-date formula to add a month for each payment. For beginning balance, we're going to link it to the $5,000. And for the payment, we're going to link it to our calculated monthly payment, which is $219. Now, I'm going to leave the principal for now and do the interest calculation. To calculate the interest, you take the beginning balance, which is the $5,000, multiplied by the monthly interest, which is 0.42%. And that's going to be an absolute value because they won't be changing while I'm copying the formula down. To calculate the principal, I take the amount of my monthly payment, which is a 290, and then subtract the interest that's calculated for each of the months. Finally, I also want to know the end balance of my loan after I make each monthly payment. Ending balance is the beginning balance minus the principal, not minus the payment. I also want to know what's the cumulative interest that I have paid on the loan over the 2 years. Now in the second row, we still have to manually enter formulas because they're different from the first row. So for our beginning balance, we're going to link it to the end balance from the previous row. The monthly payment stays the same for each month. Then the interest formula, we already used absolute value for the monthly interest rate, so we can just copy the formula down. We can also copy the formula for the principal calculation and balance calculation, and then use autofill or manually drag the formula for beginning balance and payments. Now we have our amortization table complete. We can see that we start with the beginning balance of $5,000 in loan, and by the 24th payment, our end balance is 0. During the duration of the loan, the principal amount and interest amount changes. We start with paying more in interest the beginning of the loan and then less in interest by the end of it because the amount of our loan decreases. To calculate the cumulative interest, we take the interest for the current month and add it to the interest from previous month. And then we can copy the formula down. We can see that we would pay $264 in interest during the 2 years that we have the $5,000 loan. The second way to calculate loan amortization is instead of manually calculating the principal and interest for each monthly payment, we're going to use 2 additional Google Sheets formulas. The first is a variation of the PMT formula. It has a P before the PMT to calculate the principal amount on each of the payments. So the first variable is the interest rate, which we already have the monthly interest rate. Now that's going to be absolute. It's always going to be the same. Then we have a second variable, which is a period. So that's going to be a relative variable because for each payment, it's going to be different. Then we want to have the number of periods, which is the 24 months. So that's going to be absolute value. And then we want to also link to present value of the loan, which is the $5,000 we're borrowing. The second formula is also a variation of the PMT formula with an I in front of it, because we're going to be calculating how much interest we are paying with each payment. We're going to use the absolute value for the interest rate for the month, then the relative value for the period, because that's going to be changing, then absolute value for the number of periods, which is the 24 months, as well as the $5,000 present value of our loan. And you can see that the calculations are the same, and this is even easier. So thanks so much for watching.